Just a couple of main questions that I genuinely had. So you are certainly an inspiration to all of us, somebody who went to the war zone and you know, reported courageously. I wanted to understand how such a journalist prepares herself or himself, you know, mentally to be so courageous, and how they communicate with their own loved ones that they will be going into a war zone, and you know, anything
was,
can happen.
It was quite a task, Sahil, actually, convincing my parents and also convincing my editorial team in the office, because I was just 25 years old at that point of time, and I had just started my career. I was just like you, fresh out of college, and but I was very interested in international affairs, in Gulf, and everything that was happening around the world. So I had volunteered. I had told my seniors in office that if a war breaks out, which was seeming to be quite a possibility, because the situation was becoming like that. So I had volunteered that if a war breaks out, please send me. I would like to go, because I was covering foreign affairs as a junior reporter those days. So since it was my beat, so I was following the story, so I volunteered. So it was quite a task convincing my seniors also. They said, you're a young girl, why do you want to go to the war, and that too in a country which is so far, like Iraq, nobody's going there, the troops are there, Americans are bombing, the Iraqis are fighting, so much is happening. We can't send a girl as young as you, you're just into the profession, you have a long way to go, why do you want to put your life in danger? But it was such a thrilling story, and I was always interested in conflicts and wars, and I've been studying about them since my college school days. So I said, no, just send me, because there would be media from all over the world and everybody would be going. I won't be alone. So why can't I go if everyone is going? So it took about 3 weeks for my editorial team in office to be convinced that, okay, we can send a girl to cover the war, and a young girl at that. And then once this hurdle was crossed, and I finally got my visa, I went to Kuwait, and from there I went by road to Iraq. So I got my visa to Kuwait, for Kuwait, and finally I went. And now the second challenge was, how, what do I tell my parents? Because I come from Jammu and Kashmir, and we didn't even have a journalism institute there way then. I had to come to Delhi to study. Now we have journalism institutes in Jammu, which is my hometown. So my parents, they have always been very evolved and all, and they're okay with everything. But war zone was like, our young daughter, why? So I told them, I'm going only till Kuwait, and I'm not going into the warring cities in Iraq. I will be reporting from Kuwait, which is next to Iraq. Okay? Yeah. So I told them that, don't worry, I will be safe in Kuwait. Please allow me. So they said, okay, fine, don't go beyond Kuwait. So then I went to Kuwait, and once you're in Kuwait, how can you not go to Iraq? I mean, it is
true.
History.
True.
But I had to hide it from
your parents, yeah,
for some time, till the time I arrived in Baghdad, and I reported from there, and then they saw my phonos and life. Oh, you've already reached there. You told us you'll only be reporting from. So the thing is that it is not about being courageous, or like, I am something different and you are different. No, even you can do it. Because it is not just about being courageous. It is about being passionate about your work.
True.
It's about being passionate about the story that, you know, it's been 21 years and I still get goose bumps on my skin, because every story gives me that kind of feeling. Even today, after 21 years, I get that feeling every single day. Like, I have to go back to studio today and I have to anchor my show. And I have anticipation and those ideas and thoughts in my mind, even for that show. Every single story that you do, it is every single story that matters. And you have to retain that passion all your life. That is what being a journalist is all about. And it is such a wonderful profession. Which other profession will give you a chance to travel the world?
True.
Which other profession will give you a chance to be in situations that people can only see on TV? You know, like I have reported from Iraq, I've been in Palestine, Israel, America, Pakistan, all over India, everywhere. If I was doing any other thing, or I was another professional, I wouldn't have seen the world or experienced situations been a part of floods or earthquakes, seen people in misery, seen people celebrating, all kinds of emotions, all kinds of situations, all kinds of feelings you feel yourself when you are in those situations. And I think this is the only profession in the world that gives you that opportunity to be a part of history, to be a part of every situation, to be a part of all those feelings, all those emotions, be one with people, interact with viewers. Like when you're in front of the camera, you're talking to people. You don't see them. There are thousands of people that you cannot see. You're just looking into the camera. But you know there are so many people out there who are watching you.
True.
So in a way, you're talking to people. You're communicating. So it is your responsibility to deliver just the truth, to deliver something which is not colored, to just present facts as they are. You know, because it is your responsibility, you hold that responsibility sitting in that chair in front of the camera. Because whatever you communicate to the people will have a lot of effect on them. It will influence them. So that's why when I was talking to you guys down there, I focused on the fact that it is very important to be objective as a journalist. You have to be passionate and emotional about your profession, but you don't have to be passionate and emotional about a story. It does not belong to you. You cannot have your opinion on that. You will just present all sides of opinion on that, present it to people, let them decide what they want to believe in. So as journalists, we have a lot of responsibility, and it is not about being courageous, being less courageous or more courageous. It is about being passionate about your work. And I guess it's passion that drove me to Iraq, and it is passion that drives me even today. And I hope it will be passion that will drive me till the day I am a journalist, which I hope to be all my life.
Certainly an inspiration. I mean, all our viewers would understand from each word that you spoke right now, the amount of passion that
it's
you have for
you. It's important for me to tell this to somebody like you. How old are you?
I'm 21.
You are 21, and I guess average age here is 20, 21, 19.
Yes.
It is important for me to tell this because I see hope in you, because it is important to transmit this energy, this hope to people like you, because you are going to be the carriers of journalistic ethics tomorrow. So it is important for me to say that. When I say this, I say it with all humility. I say this with all the truth, with all generosity, with all seriousness of purpose. And I hope I'm able to communicate this
certainly,
to all of you.
Certainly, ma'am. It's
I hope you guys
yes,
do this.
Yes, yes. In fact, we've been told about objectivity day in and day out as far as journalism
it's
is concerned.
It's not just on paper. It has to be practiced.
Yes.
A story does not belong to you. The profession belongs to you. The story is a story. Every perspective, neither this nor that. You present all facts. Let people decide what they want to see.
True.
Or what they want to form their opinion about, whatever Certainly. Opinion. It's not your responsibility.
Yes, very wise. One last question I had, since you are part of the industry, you know, the ins and out, you've been working with a lot of established media houses already. You've been part of the core member of building up Republic TV, if I'm not wrong.
Yes, I was. Right? Republic TV English, the first one.
Yes.
I was a part of the team in Mumbai.
And and now there are new media, which is the internet. Through the internet, there are media houses like News Laundry and The Wire and emerging in a very good pace. Do you think it's going to cannibalize the emerging, the already established media houses, or it's going to complement and make the industry into a better, more innovative?
I don't think anything will eat into anything or will cannibalize, as you said, because there is space for everything. TV will always remain. Radio will always remain. See how radio has reinvented itself with FM and all. Because when there was a research, when there was a surge of TV, people thought about radio being, you know, prehistoric and all. No, but it reinvented itself. And we have so many FM channels. People listen to FM, all those networks on radio. So everything has its relevance. It will never go. All forms of, like, you were always also mentioning in your speech that there is room for everything. Everything in journalism. TV will stay. If online media comes, Twitter is there. You know, most of the news breaks on Twitter now. Then you have so many YouTube channels. It doesn't mean that the TV channels would get eliminated. Or YouTube will not make a mark. YouTubers have also made mark for themselves. So I guess there is room for everything. Space for everything. More power to everyone and everything. We can all coexist mutually, but with responsibility, that I always focus on.
Certainly. And you have emphasized about objectivity and the passion a journalist is supposed to.
Absolutely.
Certainly.
You are a good journalist because you could pick the core of what I meant.
It's an honor to hear that, ma'am. that's all we have for the day. It was an honor to have you, and thank you so much for your time, ma'am. I hope we get to have more visits from you, and we grow from the passion that you have. To, you know, each year, if you'll be able to come and share this passion with us, it will be beneficial for the future of journalism.
I really love interacting with youngsters. They are so bright and vibrant. There's so much of energy in them. They still have to have a vision, but they have a lot of energy and a lot of passion already inside them. So it's wonderful interacting with all of you, and I wish good luck to you and to the entire team, all the batches, previous, current, forthcoming, and good luck to Rituji and everyone else, because you guys are doing a great job, and I really hope and wish that we create objective journalists, responsible journalists, and passionate journalists.
Thank you. Thank you for the chance.